In this beginner tutorial of Microsoft Excel, I want to share with you how to plot a simple chart that can represent a very simple data of my computer cells, for example, that we have over here distributed within a table over the month of March, April, May, and June. So to the left over here, you can see the type of computer. We have HP, we have Apple, we have Mac, we have Dell, Lenovo, and all that. And then at the bottom here, we have the total that we are sold at the end of every month. So I want to plot a chart that can be very easy for an ordinary person to understand this data without actually kind of looking directly into the table or looking into the details of the table. Okay, so to do that, I will need a very simple chart. And to get a simple chart, all you need to do is to make sure you select all the data. So you just click and drag and you make sure you select everything except the totals, because adding the totals will scatter the graph and the chart and it will not make any meaning to us. Okay, so you would like to select the title and the axis or the definitions of each column as well as the rows. Right, so with this selected, you can just come all the way to insert and you can come to chart over here. You can come to insert column or bar chart. You can just click and you can select a 2D chart if you want. And even by navigating across, as you hover over a given chart, you can see a sample of how that particular chart is going to look like. You can have even 3D column charts. If that particular chart that is showing is the exact chart that you are looking out for, then you can easily click it to bring it in. So let's say for this one, we're going for a 2D chart and we're going for the first one here. And you can see it over here, just created. So what you can see is at the bottom of each of the axes, you have the type of computer. You have Apple, we have HP, we have Mac, and under each computer, you have four bars. Under each, you have four bars with the performance of the bars. Okay, so over here, we can understand that these computer sales point to HP as the one that made the most sales in this particular month. And in this particular computer also, we have Mac made the most sales in this particular month of March, and this one is in the month of June, and this one also made the most sales in Dell made the most sales in the month of June as well, right? So while Lenovo made the most sales in the month of May. So depending, you can have it for yourself and you can do quite a lot over here. You can position it, maybe you can just click anywhere around the edges of the graph of the chart and you can move it around to any location. So for example, we brought it a bit down and we can come over here and zoom out so that we can have it a little bit smaller and visible. We can see the data at the top here and we can see our chart at the bottom. Okay, so once you have the chart selected, you can see that a given item is shown over here, and that item is a chart design. You can alter the chart design. You can do quite a lot from here. For example, you can change, so you can switch the rows and columns. For example, you just click to switch rows and columns and you can see it even made more sense in March. These are the cells, or these are the computers that we sold. And then you can see the one that made the highest sell is Mac. And in April, the one that made the highest sell also is Mac. In May, the one that made the highest sell is Lenovo. And in June, also it's HP. Okay, so you can see the arrangement is now quite visible and understandable. You can do quite a lot. You can change the chart type from here, just like we've shown before. You can move charts to maybe another given sheet if you want. You can move the chart to a different sheet, or you can select a given different data and plot again within this particular chart. To your left, you have the option to navigate around and you can change the chart styles. Okay, you can change the chart styles as you move across. You can see the preview of all the chart styles that we have. So depending, you can select anyone that you want and you can have it for yourself. You can click on the drop down as well to see more options. For example, you can see these ones. Maybe I may like this. You can just click on this and you can see the look is kind of fantastic. You can change the color or themes of the chart as well. So this is not a normal color. These are palettes. These are palettes. As you navigate over, you select, maybe this is more of the yellow color. This is less of the yellow color. This is more of blue color. And as you navigate over each and every one of them, you can see a preview in the chart. Okay, so let's say we'll go with this. You can change the layout as well. You can bring in the chart, you can include axes, chart titles, and many more. You can include all of them. So for example, we can put in axis, chart title, and you can see them coming up directly. So over here you have the axis. You can just double click on each one and you can type if you want. Okay, you can just double click and you can just easily type. Maybe this is computer sales, maybe from the period of April, March to June. Or alternatively, for you to chart, you can just select that particular chart, that particular text, and then you can come to the function bar over here and you just put on equal to, and you can navigate around and select a particular cell where that description is contained. So for example, I say equal to this cell and I hit enter. And you can see it takes in computer cells. You can do the same for the axis as well. So you can come to the axis, you can put type of computer, for example, or maybe cells. Maybe you can put number of cells in this type this time, or you can put the computer cells as well from here. You can just double click and put on the y-axis. You can put maybe type of computer. If you have it somewhere, you can just say equal to that particular cell and then to take it up accordingly. So one thing you should notice is you can add chart elements. For example, you can add axis manually, you can add titles, you can add chart titles as well from different angles, and you can add labels from different angles, from different positions. You can add tables, you can add arrow bars if you want, you can add grid lines as well as legends. Because when you look, you can see the legend by the right over here. Okay, the legends easily define the charts. And then once we have the chart selected, you can see you have a bunch of you have some format chart area also selected, shown by this by the right over here. So what this means is you can play around with the fill, you can change the coloration if you want. Okay, you can play around with the coloration over here. You can just change, and you can change the solid color if you want. You can see a bunch of them. You can play around with it. You can make it gradient where you have multiple choice of colors, and you can change the coloration. You have the gradient either linear, radial, or rectangular. You can try to play around with all this if you so wish. And you can play around with the shadow effect and 3D format, soft edges. You can play around with the sizing as well as other properties. You can click to see the sizing, you can increase or decrease, and you can see other properties. So feel free to play around with it. You have the text options also. You can play around with the text option if you so wish. So it's your choice, but this is just a bit about the introductory part of how you can try to generate a very simple chart from a given graph. So let's say I undo this because I prefer this look, or you can take on any look if you want. For example, let's say we go with this, and I think it kind of looks cool and fantastic. And then you can just select. So after you select, you've designed the graph, the chart, you've done everything and you're certain, you can copy this and paste it on your Word document, on your Microsoft PowerPoint if you are doing any kind of report. So you can just come over, click on it, right click, and then you can come all the way to copy, and then you can go to your maybe Microsoft Word document over here. You can just right click and paste it. Okay, and you can see it pasted very nicely. You can do the same on PowerPoint as well. So you can go to your PowerPoint and you can just right click and paste it, and you can see it comes out. Let's delete this. You can see it comes out very nicely. You can select and you can increase, you can from the edges, you can increase the sizing if you so wish. Ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit about how to plot a simple chart for a given data to make meaning to it. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to always hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.